Jeff, the defense industry and Silicon Valley have not typically had the most seamless of relationships, especially when you think about just how slow the Pentagon moves. Why don't you talk to us a little bit about how your technology actually works and what it took to really get this kind of massive contract, in the books for you?
Yeah, no, thank you for having me. It's wonderful to be here. As a company, we're based in upstate New York in Syracuse. We founded the company in 2018 out of a basement, but we're a team that's been together for almost 20 years doing this type of tech with the defense industry, with the commercial industry. And we really saw what we needed to do was bring to life next generation sensing technology in a cost-effective manner, make it available not only through our hardware sales, but through our infrastructure where we sell airspace awareness data on small drones, large aircraft. This made it ultimately much easier for the end users. So combining a mixture of dual-use commercial applications, defense, national security, our focus was making sure we have fun while addressing a safer and smarter world. So that's what really made this, a journey that was been really supported by our venture capitalists is not just that we were addressing DoD national security, but also the commerciality of a safer world.
Strategic investors like Lockheed Martin Ventures, as well as DFJ, supporting this $100 million raise, you're now worth more than $500 million. I'm interested as to how you compete against a Lockheed, how you can ensure that you're getting under the new administration new contracts for startups such as yourself.
Yeah, so not only have we brought in incredible investors like Lockheed, Booz Allen, and DFJ, and so many others, but part of the reason we did that with folks like Lockheed Martin and Booz Allen was strategic partnerships. We have a very different business model. We sell hardware direct at firm fixed price. We have this data infrastructure that's available to DoD, federal, state, local, and enterprise commercial users. So rather than trying to replace, we're a new feature, something that the defense industry is able to integrate into existing solutions very quickly. This is shown by our recent deployments all throughout the Northeast to support a wide array of drone concerns and issues, and then also our involvement in the inauguration and through our budding partnership most recently with Palantir.
Jeff, can you give us a sense of where your technology is actually being deployed? Any regions or perhaps the scale of prototypes out there currently?
Yeah, one of our largest deployments is in the DC area. It's been live since 2021. It was actually a natural progression for us after supporting the U.S. government in deployments throughout the Northeast that they asked us to help assist with the inauguration. So in support of NORTHCOM and Joint Task Force National Capital Region, and with our partnership with Palantir, we expanded our capabilities by putting our passive radar technology in that infrastructure we already had out, and we're able to provide an extremely comprehensive low-altitude to high-altitude picture on everything from small drones to manned aircraft.
Many will be thinking about New Jersey, Jeff, but many will also be thinking of the context of this race, whether it's an AI race versus US-China, whether it's a drone race versus US-China. What do you make about the risk levels right now?
The complexities of our airspace are immense. Adding small drones, adding AI, the things that you could do with drones 10 years ago versus right now is just rapidly changing. And the complexities of our airspace, all the folks that are involved, the stakeholders, not just DoD, federal, and state and local, but it's also our commercial users, the power grid, everything. This just adds for challenge and difficulty. It was big reason for starting Hidden Level was with our infrastructure, we were able to integrate all these users simultaneously for the first time ever, where they could all work off the same air picture. This gave them the ability to have very rapid response and quick decision making, which is needed as the complexity of the airspace is just getting worse.